Welcome back, promoted adventurers, to another episode of Might and Magic 6, The Mandate of Heaven with me, Magix. And today we are going to become Ghostbusters and with it Qarlagon's Haunted Mansion. So, let's go!
Push the goddamn button!
You heard what she said.
So, we are back in Whitecap right now, and I figured that after our successful last episode, where we promoted Serena from a cleric straight up to a high priest, and the power of Lloyd's Beacon, we can maybe tackle a little bit more harder dungeon in Qarlagon's estate, which we have also cleared up the surroundings in the last episode. And if we can finish this dungeon, then our wizard, Xena, will be promoted to an Archmage. This helps because she will have more spell points, more hit points, and we can finally learn here Master Air, Master Water, all the things we really need. And first thing I would like to do is reset the beacon in Freehaven so we don't lose it right now. Because it's just at the temple, and it's, yeah, in the biggest city of the world, so I think it's a good place. But what we have to do now is try to get back to Iron Fist, because that's where the mansion is. And let's see if the ship goes there. And we still have some trash to sell, so while I'm just in front of the shop, there is not much else. Unfortunately, I have forgotten where we can, the guy is that wants to buy our gong. And well, I will look it up for the next episode. Since we have our beacon in this town now, we can come back at any time. And I also figured still a use for the magic potions. You can see right now that Serena's spell points at level 20 is nearing 150 already. So we would need 15 blue magic potions to restore all spell points. But there are in fact enemies in the game that drain you of all your spell points. And if we are then surrounded or in trouble, we wouldn't have enough spell points to get out, right? Because Lloyd's Beacon costs 30 spell points, mana, whatever. And if we keep 3 magic potions in our inventory, we kind of always have an oh shit button, so to say. A way to instantly teleport out of a dungeon, excuse me. So I would like to get another blue potion, so we prevent dying a little bit more. Unfortunately, the ship is not ready right now, so let's check out the 2 stables of this town. I think one was just around the corner. I hope it's a rather large town, unfortunately. And while we are at it, we can quickly sell this stuff and check out if he has another black potion, but no, he has not. So we are fine here. And I think one of the stables is in the south of the city, exactly. And this goes back to Whitecap, just where we came from. So this one is useless. This means there is only one option left. There it is, and this leads to Darkmoor, which we haven't explored yet, and I will keep that for one for another episode. So we can either walk, I think it's to the south actually, or wait a day or two at the tavern, and I think waiting 1 or 2 days is faster. Because right now Lloyd's Beacon is there for 11 days, so if we want to keep those beacons up, can't waste so much time traveling around. And where was the pub? The pub was near the harbor. I remember this from our sewer adventure. So let's rest a night and check the ship again. Hope it works. No. And I also figured that there is still only one more dungeon left at Bootleg Bay. It was around the circus. And we have to check out the circus anyways, because that's where our little prince boy ran to. He wanted to visit the circus, if you remember. A little bit of the dialogue from the beginning of the game. And while we are at that quest, we can also try to finish the last dungeon in that area. I think we are strong enough for this. And let's check out. No horses, no chips at this day. Is it a Sunday? Yeah, okay, exactly. Should have looked it up before. On Sunday there is no action going on. But since the map is pretty much cleared out, there's nothing to explore right now. The dungeons around here are pretty tough, actually. So let's hope at Monday everything moves again. We have still 9 days left. And this one goes to Mist. That's not where we actually want to go. And I was... one of the stables was around here. Yeah, got it. Silver Cove. No, this is also a little tough right now. So much high level areas. And let's see, last option. Need a ride? Blackshire. Nope. We have no luck. No luck whatsoever. So, running back to the tavern and try it again the next day. Who's running? Soon. Just one more level in Water Magic and we can use Town Portal. Whenever we want. Have a nice night. To wherever place we want. So this will be the last episode where we probably are waiting for ships or horses. I promise. Anyways, let's see. Stable leads us to? Need a ride? Yes, Iron Fist. 4 days. Do we have the time? Yes. Need a ride? Good. Pick up the horses. Let's see. Back at Iron Fist. And let's set up Wizard Eye. And then we start flying, because that's a little bit faster. And the dungeon is actually the mansion in the swamp we have cleared up last episode when we were visiting the obelisk. And where all the bloodsuckers and what have you were swirling around. I should also activate Featherfall before we crush somehow. I think this was a Temple of Bar. Yes, this is very nice. So we can buff up a little bit here and refresh our spell points. So let's put up our resistances and finish off with heroism. And you can see now the little feather in our resistance bar. This is nice. So the bar is nearly full, actually. We have protection from poison. This one. And protection from magic. So, this is how the full bar would look like. We can still put on torchlight and heroism. And then let's quickly restore the spell points. I actually like the evil temple. It's so nice to heal completely back up for only 2 gold. And you can see with Featherfall now we are very high, but I can just press land and we take no fall damage. So here we are at Corlagon's estate. Once a residence of Archmage Terrax, Corlagon received the estate from Archibald for his service during the Succession Wars. So during Might and Magic, Heroes of Might and Magic 2. So let's enter. And you can already hear some skeletons and actually ghosts echoing through the distance. So, this is like a haunted mansion, and it will be pretty creepy, so let's see what awaits us. One door to the left, one door to the right. We start left this time. And let's see. Here we already have our first nasty opponent, the Spectre. And if you played Might & Magic 7, you might remember those guys. They can hit you unconsciousness with one single strike. So it doesn't matter if you have 250 hit points or 120, they can one-shot you. Not dead, but yeah, it's near the same. So, there is no way to protect against it in this game. We have to beat them quickly. Let's use Ice. We can now try Ice Blast, they are more crammed together. Let's see. Yeah, was not bad. But still, it's a little bit pricey. And let's try out Ice Bolt. It only costs 8, so. Good. And you can see, Arthas was just knocked out. He instantly lost 100 hit points. So, it's really dangerous around here. They don't deal that much damage, but if the effect takes in, then it gets really ugly really fast. I could run a little bit, but I hope we are still fine. And it seems like undead monsters, these undead monsters are not running, unlike the skeletons, if they are near death. I think it's not worth healing up much more, because if they can hit us down anyways, why waste more spell points, right? Good, and let's see. One evil spirit and one specter. I think the evil spirit was able to age us magically. Yes, there is actually age in this game. And you can see certain monsters and magical effects can raise your temporary age above your real age. And what age does is that you get more intelligent if you are older, but your might drops. So it's not that bad for our magical guys, but it's actually bad for our strong fighters. So, let's kill them quickly. They are also hard to hit, actually. And we have beaten them. Okay, let me quickly save. And what we are doing now is setting one Lloyd's beacon at the entrance of this dungeon. So we can always just use the church to heal now. So it kind of makes our priest not as useful anymore, but still fine. I don't intend to cheese all the way. And let's check out the next room. It seems to be a chest, and we can open it without blowing up. This is good to know. So our master disarm skill is good enough for this place. And let's check out the next door. And this door won't budge, so other direction. Only one more option to go. And lots of spirits. Let's see. Ice Blast was okay, but it's too pricey. And they are too near for Fireball. This leaves only Ring of Fire. We can use Poison Spray is better when they are really in our face, not like this. So let's continue with Ice Bolt, and we one-shot one of them. This is not bad, and we can use it twice per round. This is also good. We have to kill the Spectre somehow. We can now use the distance a little bit better and run. But you can see that they are actually quite fast, so this time hit and run tactics will not be that effective anymore. And this will be now around the point of time where bow is a little bit underwhelming. While it was certainly strong in the early game, it becomes weaker and weaker as the game progresses. And melee becomes king along with magic. The nice thing is that those ghosts these can still be afraid. That these ghosts drop rings. Let's see. This time there is no chest. Our mage is already losing spell points. Let me show you what I meant. We can recall this beacon to Freehaven. Can we assist you? And just heal up for a little bit of gold. And like this, we are already fresh again in battle. Of course, you always lose the 30 spell points to go back into the dungeon. So it's a little bit tedious right now, but as soon as we have this dungeon finished and actually earned our promotion to Archmage, we have a lot more spell points to work with. So virtually we have like 70 spell points, because we need 30 to teleport in and 30 to teleport out. Let's continue. Hope we can open this door now, because the other one seems to be locked. And we are lucky. And we can shoot them actually from here. So this hall is now very long. Let's see how much we can kill before they reach us. I could also use like a fireball. It's a good distance. I think there will be a lot more ghosts. Nice thing is that you can fire 2 fireballs per round. But now the Spectre is a little bit more in front, so... Wow, what a strong ice bolt hit. Nearly 60 damage right now. Xena is rocking, she wants her promotion. The girl is on fire, and we have lots of rings looted. We have looted lots of rings. This is correct grammar. And let's see, what do we have here? A creepy looking well? And lots more specters, so I don't intend to get knocked out. And run a little bit for this reason. Use Ice Bolt again. And another Ice Bolt. And we can maybe run for at least 2 more rounds of hitting them. Whittle them down a little bit. So we have an easier time. Good. Yeah, now he's in our face. Let's use Ice Bolts. It's very effective. I mean, we have 11 points into it. So this is the return of our investment. And only one more. And we finish them without getting knocked down. So far we are doing fine in this actually higher level dungeon. I have looked up several guides, and they suggest a lot of other dungeons before we are doing this. But I figured, why not trying to have a little challenge? Since we have even killed the the Minotaur King in the last episode. Nothing here. Let's drink it. Okay, you can't drink the water, so let's open the next door. Okay. And more ghosts. Let's try to shoot the normal one. Yeah, come on in. Like this. There. We can do this. Good hit. Good job. One more. Okay. So, seems like only the red ones will not run from us. And those other undeads are quite frightened. Out of... frightened because we are so powerful adventurers. And this is a perfect distance. Less is still on, so we should hit them hard. Good. The evil spirits should be fine. The ghosts are fodder. Good. Only the red ones are really scary. So, there is a turn. Let's press on forward first. Let's see. Don't like to be ambushed here. And I still hear skeletons. And this is the end. Then let's start at the end. and face a lot more of them. Now they are in our face. Let's try out poison spray. And it does no damage at all. And this should have been a magical aging. Yes, so you have grown older. Let's run from them. And kill them one by one. This works out. Because now we have a lot of space. And well, Arthas is down again. Let's heal him up. And good, this one is finished. And let's use some safety heals. So he can still tank some damage. And let's continue. There we have a chest. It's a bigger chest now. Let's see. Good. And we found a fairy wand of mind, with which is worth a lot of money. And some more junk. Okay, let's go to the next room. Probably more ghosts. Yes, of course there are more ghosts. And I can't hit any of them. How much more mana do we have? 32, so we can use the Lloyd's Beacon, but not another spell. Okay, one. We can deal with one alone. Good. And the rest is coming. And Serena is also aged a year. We are aging. I think there's also a potion that can cure the status, the aging. But it's another black potion. Wow, this looks so strong, but it's so weak actually. This is also weak. I expected a far better loot for such a high level place. Page from Corlagon's diary. Well, at least something. And a potion and a worthless trident. Let's read the diary. My studies with the Crystal of Terax have grown tiring. I don't think I grasp enough of the basic magics to fully understand the lessons of the crystal. My time is growing short here, and I think I will be forced to continue my studies as a lich. I refuse to let go and embrace death, not after my failure in the Succession Wars and my failures in learning magic. I'll use the time I gain from lichdom to train myself more fully in magic and plot my revenge on the Iron Fist for what they have done to Archibald and myself. So he will be probably the boss of this place. But I think we can safely throw the other scrolls away. Because if they would be important, we can always grab them back at the Oracle. But since there is no line of text that says a quest item, I think they are kind of worthless after we have read them. So, here we go. Next room. Probably more spirits. Let's see. Oh, this time we face skeletons. This should be easy. He only killed lots of you in the Temple of Ba. Come on, I see more of you. But our bless has worn off, so let's refresh bless. I want to be blessed by our High Priestess. Good. And puts on heroism again. Because Arthas will soon be a hero, as soon as we kill the evil dragon. In Darkmoor. What do we have here? Plate armor. Well, it's unenchanted. And we have cleared out this place too now. So, not much else to do on this side of the map. Let's check out this corridor. Yes, another door. And more skeletons. They are easy. nothing to fear here. It's only the ghost I'm afraid of. We are Ghostbusters. Yeah, three of them. And three are bad news. If we face them all at once. Because if they get lucky and we are unlucky, they can kill us pretty quickly. Yes, you have missed. Next one. Good. They seem to focus on our paladin. Crusader, I mean. Yes, and he is unconsciousness again. You have to take a lot of hits for the team, Arthas. But I promise one of these days you may get Destroy Undead. And get your sweet revenge. One more. And this is an evil spirit. Busted. So, three more chests, the text says. Let's save. There can always be an ambush. And a precision bow. I think we are missing the first one. No, we already have all of these. Everyone has one precision bow, I mean. There is lots of junk. This is really worthless. I will not even pick it up. This is fine. I like gold. Speed plus 5. Yeah, whatever. It's small at least. And some more junk. Sure. Please take the small stuff with us. So, the torchlight has worn off. But we only have 31 spell points, so I think this is a good recall time. Can we assist you? Let's heal back up. Good. Let's use Bless again. And Terrorism again. Can we assist you? And let's recall the beacon. So, only one more corridor in this part of the dungeon, and then we are done here. Hopefully we find a switch to open the door on the left side. So, let's speed it up a little bit, and let's see, what do we have? Another door, of course. Seems, yeah, like skeletons. Now we can use our spell points again. Good. Probably some ghosts. No ghosts. I will not search the trash. But there seems to be something blue on the map. Like treasure or something. But I can't reach it. What do we have here? This seems odd, actually. But I can't see a switch or something in there. So, let's try to open the door. Okay, it worked. No traps here. And it goes deeper. Deeper into the mansion. Let's see, another door. Oh. Are there ghosts in there? Yes, there are a lot of undeads down there. Can we lure them in? Yeah, they are flying up. This is fine. They can fly in, and then we can kill them one by one. Let's use Ice Bolt again. Got one. I hope they will not get stuck. Got two more. Are there more spirits? Yeah, there are a lot more spirits. An whole army of spirits! I hope we can beat them. Like this, it's still fine. At least they are not that tanky. Now there are a lot of specters. Can I hit you? Yes. Got this one. Ice bolts. This was a weak hit, unfortunately. 12 is fine. 26. Don't hit our wizard. Okay. Good. The Spectre is down. This is the most dangerous one. Don't care about a few years of aging. And let's continue. Let's see. Yeah, there they come. And another year of aging. Scary. Come on, guys. Hit them. And another year of aging. Wow, you have aged 3 years, Conan. And the temple cannot heal this, actually. You need the black potion for it. Okay. And more are coming. So after this we have earned our title of Ghostbusters. And don't be afraid. Don't be afraid. We are fine. We can do this. It's all for Xena. Got that one. These are now skeletons on the bottom. Seems like we have beaten all the ghosts. We could use Featherfall and jump down there, because there is actually a treasure chest. But let's continue here first. Let's check it out. Okay, some more skeletons. I'm not afraid of you guys. At this point, you are too easy to beat. Let's heal up again. Where is my healing spell? We have still 30. Okay, this was like a teleporter, but it only teleported us down the road. Okay, sure. Saves us the walking. What do we have here? Nothing. Oops, found more ghosts. They were ambushing us again. Let's put on Bless. And try to melee them down. Come on, guys. Good. Okay, we are fine. Let's see. What do we have here? Nothing. And this is another long way. More ambush. No, but this is like a closed room. And another specter. And it's already behind us. It's really quick on its not existing feet. Good. We are kind of dropping. Of course, we can always teleport back if it gets too hard. For now, we are fine. Let's see, what do we have here? Corpse. Okay, will this kill us if we try to grab it? No, nothing here, but man, you have lost your head over some ghosts. Okay, let's see, what do we have around this corner? Like a bridge? More ghosts? Yeah, of course there are more ghosts. Of course there are more ghosts. It's like the ghost mansion. Let's cure wounds. Let's see, do you come up? No. We have to pull them in. Okay. Come on, guys. We lack heroism. Yes. Without heroism, our damage is too low. So, Some more? No, seems like skeletons that can't reach us. Poor you. And another door. And more skeletons. And then we are at the end of this way. So I hope we still are searching for a switch to the other side of the dungeon, actually. And another door. And a treasure chest.
Got it.
Good. What do we have here? Sacred spear. Oh my god. 13 damage. Plus 9.
I don't know.
This looks like a strong spear and a strong ring. But we need some space, so put the junk in there. Let's take the sacred spear with us. Soon we will be able to enchant it, so I'm eager to see what it can do. And then I think the next goal is to push up sword to master, so we can actually start dual wielding. That will be nice. And let's see. Just a door that leads to another door. And more ghosts. And a switch! So, seems like this will open the door in the beginning. Yeah, I see you. You can't hide from us. And the specter got him. But there's still a ghost in there. Let's cure wounds. No, we have beaten them. Let's press the button. This will probably open up the door in the beginning of the dungeon. So we could now teleport back and are just at the beginning again. But let's put on the featherfall. And actually jump down. Because I want to see what we have down here. Besides some skeletons. And there are two more doors. Okay, let's check out what we have here. This goes down. And here we have some more ghosts. And this is bad. One of our healers is down. Let's put a little bit distance between us. Because if both healers get down, we may have a problem. I mean, I could always Lloyd's Beacon back, but I don't want to walk all the way to here again. Come on. Let me heal your wounds. He's actually stuck a little bit, and our wizard's eye has run out. Yeah, now we are missing one spell point to teleport back. But that's still fine for now. Yeah, let's continue in this way. Maybe this will lead back to the other room. Okay. Some more skeletons first. Let's refresh Bless. And shoot them down. Okay. Then let's see what we have in the next room. Good. Let's go on. What do we have here? This is fine. Nothing here. That doesn't seem right. After so much enemies we have beaten down. Okay. And let's hurry up in the other direction. Maybe there is a teleporter or something that will drop us here. They also see something around here, on the map at least, but can't reach it. Do we have another door and an intersection with another door? So, this is another button and some enemies in there. Yes, more ghosts waiting for us. Then we can press this button too. Maybe we actually had to jump down here. Because we need more than one button to open the door in the beginning. Let's check out this door. Some more fodder skeletons. Yes. Good. And another long way. And another corpse. They really like their head on sticks. Oh man. Whoa. And a lot of specters coming. Do we need heroism again? Good. And two more. At this point we can use Ice Bolt again. Good. Should focus on one. Nice. And Arthas is down again. Come on. This can get so annoying. Okay, this should be fine. Nothing here. A lot more. Whoa! This was by accident. Aha. And it's only junk. Here I thought. Oh! Okay, it seems like a big treasure chest. Yeah, well, okay. At least it's worth something. So. Also some hidden treasure rooms here. There is nothing. And there is a switch. But we can't reach it, actually. But we have a telekinesis scroll. So maybe. Yeah, that did the trick. Cool. So, some more skeletons waiting for us. But we killed them quickly. And what do we have here? Yeah, well, some fire resistance, not bad. And here is no water in there. Seems like you can jump down there, actually. And there are enemies at the bottom. Let's see where this will lead to. But it seems to lead back up. Okay, some more ghosts. Feels like we are going in circles. But we are hitting the switches, so I think we are still on the right way, actually. Let's use Bless again. And our sorceress is afraid, so let's remove the fear. And heal up a little bit. You can really tell how much magic points Serena has. She is constantly using heals and buffs and is not running out of spell points. So I'm really happy if we finally get the promotion for our wizard. Because then we can use a lot of spells. And we didn't even put any points into meditation yet, which can boost up spell points even more. And yes, more spirits. More evil spirits and specters. Okay. Yes, this time they got Conan. And I have the feeling we have to soon teleport back. Because our spell points are dropping lower and lower. As are our hit points doing. They are also kind of dropping. One might be fine. Yes. Good. Two more. Then I hope we are somewhat at the end of this dungeon. Because it gets a little bit tedious right now. Okay, now we are at least in the yellow. The scary thing now is that if we hit any trap, we will probably die instantly. And okay, seems like we are back at the beginning. So this is a perfect time. time to quickly go and heal. There was a Temple of Bar near us, right? Yes, exactly, the other side, so this will be rather quickly. And I forgot actually to use the fountains at the castle. Those would have been helpful too. Doesn't matter right now. Let's use the Temple of Bar, our good friends. And then the only way left is to jump down this well, as we have seen. Good. And then we are probably nearing the end, but we also have to jump down to the first big room where the skeletons were. So maybe that's it where I start. Because there was a treasure chest down there. Is there another way? Yeah, seems like we have also opened up this way. So we have still this little bit of the room left here. And the point where we could jump down to the skeleton. So yeah, we start with the skeletons that you can see on the right side of the map right now. Most of the things here are dead, so this should be the right way. This was where the trash was. And now this should be the room with the catwalk. So let's use Featherfall. And let's just jump down like this. And quickly kill the skeletons. I don't want to press these big piles. Because the last time we clicked them, they either drained our might. Or killed us. Remove curse, yes. And let's try to open this chest. Good. And we found our third mana potion. So we have built our oh shit button. Let's put the horseshoes to the other side so looks a little bit more tidy. When we have piles of weakness, of curse, and of weakness again. And a wonder maze. This is actually a good maze, but our death maze is still stronger. So, let's use this way. And of course more ghosts. And we shoot two down. This was easy this time. We lost no hit points at all. Let's see, we weren't here before. So far we have hit three buttons. So I hope that anything that is locked in this dungeon is now available. More ghosts. Has anybody counted how much ghosts we have killed so far? Because I didn't. It's really crampy in this place. Who builds a mansion like this? Makes no sense at all. No beds, no kitchen, no television. Only long hallways with nothing in between. This seems like a shitty building. And more ghosts down there. Let's check out the top first. Because it seems to be another circle. And we came out of the other well. Okay, so there was something behind it indeed. So we have cleared out another short way back to the entrance. So we have two more ways left. This one and the part where we could jump down. Let's beat those enemies first. And you are not falling, eh? These are the weak ones. This is a strong one. Okay. Got this one. All miss. So let's try Ice Bolt. This is good damage. Okay. And we miss because we don't have Bless anymore. Should have noticed this. Ice Bolt and Terrorism. Those long ways. kill a lot of our duration time, and we found another switch. So, this is the fourth one. And it's still going deeper and deeper. Maybe someone was digging for oil or something. And Corlagon needed to become a lich to dig deeper and deeper. And it's green now. This is a good sign. This is another hidden... Ah, this seems to be the well or what have you where you could fall down. And we found this would be the way to find the other switch. So, since we have pressed this switch 2 now, where do we have to go next? And there was still this part of the map that we couldn't reach before. So maybe we have to go there. Wait, this is... This was where we jumped down. So we have to use the shortcut back to the entrance, I think. Of course, we can always teleport back to the entrance, thanks to Lloyd's beacon. If we are going the wrong way, but I think we are still fine for now. And let's see. Two more ways. One goes there. And this was a part, so I think if we are going this way, we should be right. Let's speed it up again. No more noise. The light is green, so right now we are safe. We have to go to the catwalk again and not fall down. Careful. I know myself. And... Yeah, we teleport down this way. And now we should be near. Here we have yellow light again, and we can see that a door has opened. So, I think we are right. Let's quickly refresh our buffs. Before we are probably going to the boss of this dungeon. Arisen and Featherfall. And let's jump down and continue the adventure. Let's see, what do we have? Okay. More long rooms and another door. And we found a power lich, which seems to be the boss of this lair. So it's probably Corlagon. And he has a lot of hit points and a lot of firepower. Let's try Ice Blast. Only 18 damage. This is not a lot, and he deals around 70 damage. So this is a real boss fight. Let's see. I wanted to lure him out. And now we are actually in his room. With some of his minions, but I'm not afraid of those skeletons. It's more like I want to face the Lich in melee. And I think we have to do this. And now we have to use all of our firepower. So, give me some good damage. Okay, I can use the ice ball to one-shot them at least, so we don't get cursed. And focus my melee attacks on them. I guess you can try to hit the Skeleton Lord. Man, they are hating on our sorcerers. Do I have a good AoE? Poison spray was worthless. And we have still put all of all of our skill points into water magic, so I think it's still Ice Bolt. And I think we have to use Shared Life pretty soon. Actually now, because otherwise our healer will die. So, let me show you Shared Life. And this looks a little bit better. Xena is now fully healed. And while Conan looks a little bit down on hit points, 90 is still a lot. You can see that everyone has now 90. Let's focus some more on them. They are now both red, so let's try out Ring of Fire. So the next ring should kill both of them. Come on, guys. Now don't die on me. Yeah, next. It probably kills you. Good, you survived. Now let's use the healing to counter. And more ice. Yeah, this was a good hit. And killed him! This was your revenge, Conan. Nice, we killed the boss. So the only thing left now is to get our prize. Let's open it with the right guy on safe. Nice! We found the Crystal of Terrax. So, congratulations! We can now become Archmage. And, like I have feared, we are ambushed, just as we want to leave. I could teleport out right now, but let's finish them. Because I am not cheap. Good. I think there was one more. We are killing all ghosts. We are fulfilling our job of being Ghostbusters. And with this, we have cleansed the evil of this mansion, so Arthas can sleep well this night. Let's call our beacon at Freehaven, because the nice thing is that the ship goes to Mist. We have checked out it before. But before we sail there for 4 days, I want to refresh the beacons that we have, so that we don't lose them. Especially not the one in stone. At stone. Because we can only... Or is it important? At the frozen highlands here, probably. Otherwise we have to walk all the way through the Magias again. And we can always try to clear out this mountain top to fly always back to the city of Whitecaps. So I think it's worthwhile to take the time and refresh the beacon here. And then we can take the ship to Mist. Probably sell the stuff right here. But since it's night right now... Ah! Damn it! It's too late, I think. The ship will probably not have opened. Because it's already deep in the night.
Can we assist you?
And let's see. It's just around the corner, on the other side of the map of this town. And I hope you go to Mist still. Yeah, it's closed, damn it. 3 hours too late. Then, unfortunately, I have to take the tavern again. And check out the chip. And since this chip doesn't want to bring us to Mist, we can recall at the mansion, go outside, and let's see if the ship at Iron Fist brings us to this goddamn island. Let's put on fly. Let's fly to the ship at double speed. Put on Featherfall to be sure, to be safe, and it was in this direction. There is no Dragon Tower here, so we are safe in the air. And let's see. No, it's not going there either. This is so tedious, this traveling. Let's see. 1 day to the arena. I think I never have shown you the arena yet, right? Yeah, then let's quickly make an arena game, I think.
Need a ride? Hitch up the horses.
At the arena, you are in a special area. And you can now choose various difficulties, and then the whole arena will fill up with monsters, depending on the difficulty we have chosen. And if we lose, we are dead. But if we win this fight, then we earn money depending on the difficulty that we have chosen. And in Mighty Magic 7, there was actually a promotion quest for your knight, where you had to win 3 battles at the second last difficulty to actually get to the last promotion, I think. The knight, you had to do like 5 knight rounds. So let's try out the knight, yeah, sure. And what do we have here? Lots of difficult enemies, it seems. We have gargoyles, which are pretty nasty because they are immune to physical damage. The lieutenants you already know. We have werewolves and some nasty evil eyes. You actually fight in the last dungeons and in our power leash. So sorry guys, but this is way out of league. Hitch up the horses. Yeah, I will not even bother to show you those guys right now because I know that we are dead. Sorry for teasing, but let's use the other difficulty. At least in Mighty Magic 7 it was not that hard at night. So I wonder if we would have spawned some dragons or something if we would have chosen Lord. That's crazy at level... I mean, we are level 20, right? So what is the game giving us? Death Knights already? Maddening Eyes? Oh my god. Let's choose Squire, and this seems more like our punching class. So we face some weaker liches, normal lich and greater lich, but they are still strong. And specters again. So this is all. Let's run back, because they are shooting. And in this position only one can shoot at us. If at all, because he's pretty far away. So we can start by focusing down the specters. Good. This is easy, because we have lots of space. And to the right is another specter. Let's try to get him. And the liches are of course shooting at us. And you could see that they are dispelling all of our buffs. So they are pretty dangerous in packs. And there will be dungeons where we will face lots of liches, to be honest. And then it gets really dangerous, because we won't have up less, we don't have heroism and any other protection spell we could put up to protect against their magic or kill them faster will be not available, so... Let's try to kill him in melee. We should still be fine. But they are also dealing a lot of damage. This is where healing comes. It's important still. And I wanted to press the spell. Good. Got this one. And two more. Two more on the other side. So let's heal up. And let's try to focus them down. Let's kill the small one first. Good. This was a fast kill. And this one is the last. And then we have won at least this battle. Don't die now. Okay, you wasted your turn on dispelling. But we don't have any spells, so... Wasted 2 turns. And let's see what our reward is. 2000 gold. Not bad. So Squire seems very doable, but you can see already those enemies put quite some stress on our party. And I can just say again, we wouldn't have won against the Death Knight, Maddening Eyes and Power Lich group. It's too much damage at once. So, let's check out this ship again. And here we go to Mist. We have done it. And I think there is no more dungeon here, but we can go to Bootleg Bay next and finish the dungeon in this area. And then we have cleared all beginning areas, I think, besides the Snurgle's cave in Iron Fist. His Grace, Albert Newton. Archmage, great news! I remember what you need to find, the Crystal of Terrax. Oh, you seem to have found it already. Well, perfect. I can train you to Archmage then. The first Archmage, Terrax, used this crystal to master the elements. Fire, earth, water and air all formed together to make it. And from analyzing it, he learned a great deal about elemental magic. In addition, its effect on light led him to his discoveries of light and dark magic. Since that time, the study of this crystal has guided every new Archmage. Let me show you the secrets of the crystal, Archmagi. So, we have done it! We have now an Archmage in our group. And to end the episodes, I will train the group, because the second promotion quests give a lot of experience. So, you can see that we already trained 6 level with this, and are losing all of our money. So, Archmage, we can now use Lloyd's beacon perfectly. And we have probably lost it on our training, yes, so we are empty right now. But nevertheless... Hello. Master Water, here we go. So, and the first thing we do now is set the beacon here. Just because we can. And you can see we have now 190 spell points available. And another thing, Master Air. Now we are master in air too. This allows us to have a very long fly duration. And Starburst now drops 16 stars. So we can now clear big groups on the map pretty quickly through Starburst and Lloyd's Beacon. So we can continue in Whitecap next episode and try to clear out the map. And we can become a Master Fire if we put it up to rank 12. But I think I will not do this now, because I actually want to push up Dark Magic. I guess there is some merit in getting up Meditation to Expert to improve our magic points. Now it's only 15, but by mastering it we can triple the effect. It's a nice little passive boost. And then let's put up Dark Magic, which is the strongest magic school, but also the most pricey. So what else can we do? Bodybuilding for some more hit points would be fine, at least for expert. And let's keep those 6 points for now. And for Serena, we can check the masteries of the self magic, and I don't know how much skill points we need for those, but I also would like to get bodybuilding and meditation up to expert. And yeah, I keep those 37 for now. I will search up for the next episode where we can fight the mastery of these skills, and let's see how much we can master. Especially, I will sell all the stuff off camera so we have enough money again. And for Conan, you are pretty stacked right now. I want to get your sword and axe up to master, which usually is at 7, but we have seen that water magic master needed 12 points, so I'm not sure how it is in this game. So I will keep those 23 points also for now. And for Arthas, I also put the sword up to 7. Get the spear a little bit higher. So if the sword only needs 7 to master, we can then also use the spear at a very good skill level. And the disarm was fine for such a higher level dungeon. We can go 7 for identify item, so maybe we are able to master it. And mastering plate would also be good to make you faster. But for now, until we find the respective master trainers, I will keep you at 18.2. And at this point, I will wrap up the episode, check the loot that we have made. Maybe there is something good in here. If yes, I will show you at the beginning of the next episode. If not, then we will continue to Bootleg Bay and finish the dungeon there. And yeah, maybe search out some master trainers. And our reputation right now is angelic, since we are Ghostbusters. So, yeah, thanks for watching, and till next time!